market over there. So I won't support the motion either, because I think it really, we have the money to do the improvements that we need in Williams. It was been allocated, it's been waiting for that allocation for a long time, and now shifted priorities. And that is sad, because now we're gonna, we don't have the money to purchase the land on Boronda. We're gonna do half of the work, and then the developers might not like what we do. And so I can just see it scraping up everything that gets done, and that goes, you know, wasted dollars and wasted traffic fees. So I won't support it. I think it's, this decision has been made in the backs of folks that are already there. They're very crossing, and we're talking about in the next 10 to 15 years, whenever that development across Boronda gets developed. So I think it's unfair to the residents of that area. The money's there, we could have done, we could do it. We just, I guess we don't, we have shifted our priorities.
Okay. All right, yes, Gloria.
I just want to say that every child is important in the city of Salinas.
Okay, thank you. I would like to, I'd like to comment before we call for the question. You know, in many ways, this conversation is unfortunately. Oh, I'm sorry, Steve. I thought. No, go ahead.
I don't want to repeat what's been said, but you know, this Walmart issue here, I think people underestimated the impact it's going to bring in traffic. So once that store opens, when it opens, which I think is going to be sometime this year, once that happens, I mean, we got the, what did Brian say, $800-$900 gorilla that's ready to come out of its cage, and we got to be prepared to accept what traffic impact it's going to bring. And if we don't, God, that traffic line is going to be back in the county, not just in the city. So I think we got to be prepared for it and make that as a priority here, because it is going to bring thousands more than what we face right now, and we know it's ugly right now. So that's all I had to say.
Okay, thank you, Steve. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to. You know, in many respects, this is a conversation we may unfortunately have to have far more often than we prefer. You know, to Gloria's comment, whether it's, I don't know how many families we were dealing with, but last night at Cali Cebu, that, you know, they were worried about their kids just crossing the street to whether it was to run over to Christ the King, or because there's so many kids there. I mean, it's a handful by comparison versus the thousands that on Williams Road, versus whether it's 600 or 800 at McKinnon. You know, these are just simply choices we ought not have to make, but we do. And because we do, on the near term, I think, or for the foreseeable future, I think it is important that we move things forward incrementally, strategically, and specifically when we can. And, you know, Boronda was an F even before Walmart, and I know there can be some back and forth. In many respects, all Walmart is doing what we hoped Home Depot would do, be wildly successful and create all sorts of problems in terms of traffic flow with something that was already an F. But one of the things we do believe is a viable regional retail sector can expand our tax base. And if we recall when we were together a couple weeks ago, our sales tax base is down 33% or 30%, and fully a third, when you include the auto center, of our sales tax base is in that general area. So getting healthy there, you know, think back a few years ago, what is now $18 to $19 million in terms of sales tax. At one point that was $24 million a year. So it has upside, it can provide resources, so it's critical we address that. But when I mentioned thinking incrementally and specifically, you know, on April 6th, this council is going to have a study session about a planned massive expansion of our redevelopment area that in fact includes Williams Road, that begins to, if this council approves and is receptive and can move that forward, begins to create tools to address Williams Road as we should. So the simple fact is we have the opportunity to make some progress on something that was an F. We know strategically city staff is beginning to tee up for our consideration the tools to address Williams Road. And I think that's important, and you know, I'll certainly be supporting of that. So just as we, for instance, had to make a budget decision that, look, we're approving a framework because we have to work a little more methodically, deliberately, strategically, step one, step two. I think tonight we ought to do the work we need to do on Bronda, knowing staff is preparing some options to allow us to consider this Williams Road situation, because and I appreciated the comment that council member Sanchez made, you know, we're going to have to address Williams Road if there's going to be a Cesar Chavez library expansion, if there's going to be an Al-Sal campus, you know, there it's going to be busy. So we're going to have to work to get tools to address all that. So, but for tonight, I think this is the right action for the council to take. And I certainly believe there are other opportunities in the pipeline to address the very, very legitimate concerns that have been expressed by the entire council. So there is a motion, there's a second, we have commented, and I will ask Terry to call for the question.
Councilmember Barnes.
Aye.
Councilmember Barrera. Councilmember De La Rosa.
Aye.
Councilmember Lutz.
Aye.
Councilmember Sanchez.
No.
Councilmember Villegas.
Aye.
Mayor Donahue.
Yes. Okay. All right. That takes care of that. We are through considering, we are going to go to closed session, and we are not going to have a meeting next week, right?
No.
What if we want to?
We can.
So it would appear that we will not return until March 23rd to consider train trestles and a whole other bunch of stuff. So we're off to closed session, which I'm told will be pretty darn exciting.